it back?
Yeah, I was just wondering, why don't they just eliminate them? Never mind criterion animals and no yes, but just wipe it out to be fair to animals, because it's not fair. The animals are not happy. Like, forget all nitpicking. Like, the animals need to be free. They love born to be free. They should be free. So this is a bunch of, I don't know, I just think the main thing is the animals' welfare. Forget people and blah, blah, blah. The animals, they want to be free. They're born free. They're meant to be free. Like, humans have no right to be doing what they're doing to animals. I went to a creature conference in London, England this summer, and they're trying to get the church more involved because somebody has to look out for the animals. Globally, they're being treated horrendously, horrifically. So I'm supposed to go to churches and get them to get more active, but this is really weird that this happened. But our government, like, come on, Canada, why can't we be compassionate to animals, slaughtering the seals and all this about prohibited exotic animals? It shouldn't be in the picture. It should not be an option. Don't make it better, worse, rules this, that, and no, none of it. You can have a dog, you can have a cat, a horse. Like, really, bottom line, this is all going in circles and people and their money and their businesses, but that's BS. The animals are wild and they're born to be free like we are, and they have the right to be free. I wish Rob Laidlaw was here, because I learned a lot from him. There's four basic things with animals, and one of the big ones is freedom. Freedom to live where they want in nature with their other animals, eat what they want when they want. That's the bottom line. This makes me so angry.
So Rob was at our last
And people are greedy. They don't care about the animal. It's all money. It's all BS. We know that. We know that. You know, and the States is horrific. They're coming across these people. The animals are so terrible shape there. But I don't want Canada to be like that. And we're mean to animals. We're not compassionate Canada. The seal slaughters, fur coats, like, I'm really passionate about this, and it's in the Bible. We're supposed to look after the animals. They're God's creatures. If anybody believes in God or whatever, or their creator, they are meant to be here to look at. We're supposed to look after them, respect them. They have a right to life and freedom. Like, how would you like to be living like them? Put yourself in their shoes. Do unto others as you'll have them do unto you. Do you want to be locked up and handed around? No. It's so basic to me. It's so simple.
Thank you.
So compassion.
I have a new hand over here, and then a.
So just like a side point on what you're saying, I think we definitely need to make a distinction in this conversation between wild-caught animals and captive-bred animals. Captive-bred animals. I'm sure we have all kinds of disagreements in this room as to whether or not we should be breeding exotics in captivity, such as ball pythons or flamingos or anything of that nature. But that, I think, is a different discussion. Right now we're talking about if it was bred in captivity, could we have it in the city limits? As opposed to wild-caught animals, I know there's a lot of very strong feelings in this room about how they should stay wild, and I agree. But we aren't really talking about here whether or not we should be taking things out of the wild and bring them in. So much as most of these animals on this list are all captive bred, things like kangaroos haven't been exported from Australia in a very long time. Sorry, my voice cracks when I talk to people. and so these are all animals born in Ontario. They were born here. They can't go back into the wild. There's nowhere for them to go. So I think that's just a little bit of a distinction we should have while having this conversation, is if we're talking captive bred animals, what we should be doing.
We should be captive breeding.
Okay, thank you. So I have a hand over here, and then one over here, and then one there. So go ahead.
Yeah, so maybe just, this is not the point I wanted to make, but maybe just to kind of work up with this discussion. I mean, you have captive bred animals, you have wild caught animals, and you have rescued animals, you know, and I think depending on your values, you might, you know, have a different appreciation as to which ones could benefit from that life in captivity if it's a rescued animal. You know, a point was made earlier that all animals should be released into the wild so they can, you know, live long and healthy lives, but that is just not the reality. If you take a wild, you know, a rescued animal that had been in captivity for a long time and you release it, you take a captive bred animal and you release it, those animals would be worse off than if you just maintain them
in
the environment.
They successfully release dolphins and whales. It can happen.
I think that's,
okay,
so yeah, that science I think is pretty contested, but the point that I wanted to make was with respect to the third point there, the idea of prohibiting, private companies, that was the term I wanted to touch on. So I'm not sure why you're necessarily focusing on companies. You could have, you know, a company like Ray's, you know, that has a complement of, I don't know, 50 animals, and you could have a private collector with 30 cats in a barn, you know. So I think whether you're the Toronto Zoo, Little Ray's, or you're a traveling road exhibit, or just an individual collector, I think the same rules should apply to you. So you should demonstrate on the one hand that you're capable of looking after these animals. On the other hand, you should demonstrate the ability to, you know, maintain some sort of level of public health and safety. So, you know, I don't really know that the entity is really what matters. I think what matters is the set of criteria that you bring to the table as an owner of those animals. And I agree that, you know, frankly, from my personal perspective, as you know, as a human being in society, I don't think that animals should be kept in captivity for the entertainment of others. Although I do appreciate that there are circumstances under which, you know, those animals might actually benefit from that life in captivity as opposed to the alternative. So I think given that we, you know, the point had been made earlier, if we really truly cared about the welfare of animals, we wouldn't be having these conversations, but we're having conversations about which animals to add to the list, you know, how do we define education? Because I think there's a big enough portion of society that's comfortable with keeping these animals in captivity, and that's, you know, city hall or city council, you're gonna take the public kind of view and the overall public perception or whatever kind of galvanizes the majority of the folks. And you're gonna try to improve that in some way. And so you're looking to improve, you know, what animals are added, you're looking to better define what is perhaps a dangerous animal. And I think in that context, in that world, we should be looking at what makes for a good caretaker of the animals, both from the perspective of ensuring public safety and maintaining the welfare of the animal.